Hi, thank you for tuning in to Mama Sanity again. Today I want to give y'all just a little inspiration. Instead of doing some devotionals and prayers, I got some stuff off of Pinterest, some inspirational things, and I feel like it's kind of been laid on my heart. I feel like this is really important to share with y'all today because, you know, summertime's coming up, right? And so this is the time where everybody cramps in exercise or cramps in a slam diet and tries to get, you know, the beautiful bikini bodies or, you know, the big muscle, you know, for the beach and the pool. And that's all fine and great and that's awesome. And I exercise and I encourage exercise and eating healthy, and that's awesome. But this is really made for people who have a low self-esteem about themselves and who feel like it doesn't matter how much I diet or exercise, I'm not going to be beautiful. No matter what I wear, I'm not going to be beautiful. I know there's lots of times that I myself need to read this. So I hope this encourages those people who don't feel beautiful to think differently about themselves. So here we go. Hey you, can I tell you a secret? You are so beautiful. Whether you're curvy or skinny, tall or short, whether your hair is blonde or brown, or black or red, whether you have braces or glasses, or scars from hating that beautiful body you're in. No one has the same sparkle in their eyes, or shine in their hair, or cadence in their voice. There's never been anyone like you. There isn't right now, and there never will be. Now take a look at the goodness in the mirror and love yourself. Don't be afraid of being different. Be afraid of being like everybody else. I wanted to share that with you because it is so true. You know, we get this image inside of us of this beautiful, perfect size zero image of what we should be. And, you know, we're not all supermodels. We're not all going to be bodybuilders, and we're not all perfect tens. And that's life. That's how it is. You know, God created some people to be, you know, picture perfect and beautiful, and you know there's a lot of Photoshop shopping going on, you know, and stuff like that. But still, everybody is unique and beautiful in their own way, and the important thing is to be you. Don't be like that person that you see on TV, okay? You know, there's been several times where my husband and I are watching TV, right? And we see somebody on TV and I'm like, wow, she's, you know, beautiful, you know, and in my mind she's like a perfect 10 or whatever. And so she goes from a 10 to being, you know, she starts talking, you know, if it's a reality show or something, and you start getting to know her personality and it's not so nice. And so she goes from being a 10 to being like a 5. And that's what I'm saying. It truly is your beauty on the outside. First, it's the beauty on the inside that counts. Okay, I've had 4 C-sections and my husband has seen my stomach and then my insides cut open. I have puked all over him. He sees me all the time without makeup. He sees me dog tired and sick, and he still thinks that I'm beautiful and loves me. And that is a true person. When I say a true person, I mean a person that's gonna see you at your utmost worst, but still love you for you. Why? Because it's not the outward appearance. It is the inside that really matters, and your inside qualities and your inside personality. So if you're going out there and you're doing your best and you're, you know, you're sharing the love and you're helping people and you're smiling and you're being upliftful and joyful, that is more beautiful than some of these models that are out there who are mean and hateful and selfish. And I'm not saying just because you're beautiful, you're mean and selfish. That's not what I'm saying. There's tons of beautiful people that are just wonderful, wonderful people. But what I am saying is it's on what the inside that matters. And everybody, there is a perfect pair for everybody. And if you haven't found your perfect mate, just be patient and be calm. Everybody has somebody out there for each other, and God made, you know, when he made you, he knew that you were going to have that lifelong partner. So you just got to be patient for that. Okay, there's one last thing that I want to read to you, a little bit of encouragement as well. You are awesome. Yes, you really are. You matter more than you know. You are more amazing than you think, more capable than you believe. You can love more than you imagine. You can make a difference. You can be fierce to protect those you love. You can make mistakes and get up and you can try again. You can learn and you can grow. Remember, you don't have to do it all alone. You can be warm and kind and loving. You can be happy, sad, or angry, or whatever you need to be at that moment. It doesn't change the thing that you are, flawed or scared. Be confident, be brave, be yourself, because you are awesome. I wanted y'all to hear that today because I wanted you to know that we can feel many things. Okay, we can feel, you know, angry or sad or ugly or fat or, you know, short or, you know, I'm short and, you know, people make fun of me all the time or whatever. And I, you know, my comeback is I say great things come in small packages. So the whole thing, but when I was like in high school, they would call me a troll and stuff. And that kind of really hurt my feelings because I'm like, great, you know. But over the years, I've learned to just take it in, take it with a grain of salt and just put something positive in it. And that's where I got my, well, great things come in small packages, you know? And you roll with it and you find the beauty in yourself. Because if you love yourself, then other people are gonna love you. You know, I always tell my kids, you know, like my daughters are sometimes when, you know, they're getting dressed or whatever, they're like, I look terrible, this looks terrible, I'm so ugly, you know, and I you know, I teach them, you are never ugly, first of all, and I'm not just saying that because I'm your mom, you truly, like, you're beautiful, everywhere we go, they're like, you have such beautiful kids, and I'm like, thank you so much, but I tell them, you are very beautiful, and I'm like, so if you don't like what you're wearing or whatever, change it or whatever, I think that looks great, or, but you need to love yourself, because it's hard for people to love you if you don't even love yourself. You know what I'm saying? So I hope this is encouraging to somebody out there. Like I said, I just felt like somebody out there needed to hear that you are awesome, you are beautiful, and God made you for a purpose and for a reason, and everybody has something special in them. So until next time, I hope y'all stay sane. Thanks.